Hey guys, it's Kevin, and this is my long-term review of the OnePlus 11. This phone launched about 3 months ago, and I wanted to give you my updated thoughts, what I like, and what I dislike about using this phone. I'll also compare it to my preferred Android phone, the Galaxy S23 Ultra. The OnePlus 11 has high-end specs, but starts at $700. Is this the return of the flagship killer? Let's find out. So most of us know the story of OnePlus. They started out as a new company, and they created smartphones based around user comments and feedback. OnePlus offered the most bang for your buck and was labeled as a flagship killer. But over time, OnePlus increased their prices, released a few models, and became just like any other smartphone company. Now they're kind of returning back to their roots with only one phone, the OnePlus 11. It's supposed to compete with the Pluses, Pros, and Ultras of the world. Okay, I'm gonna start off with the specs. For $700, the OnePlus 11 will have a Snapdragon 8 Gen 2, 128GB of UFS 3.1 storage, and 8GB of LPDDR5X memory. And for $100 more, you can double the storage and memory, and it'll be the faster UFS 4.0. No matter which spec you get, the OnePlus 11 is a really snappy phone. Just navigating around the UI and opening apps is buttery smooth. And hardcore multitaskers will be glad to know that you can do split screen, floating window, and picture-in-picture without any issues. The S23 Ultra is using an optimized chip with a slightly higher clock speeds, but I don't notice a big difference in speed, and this costs $500 less. In 3 or 4 years, I expect the OnePlus to still perform great. Alright, having all this power means nothing if a phone can't last a whole day. The OnePlus 11 has a 5000mAh battery, which is great on paper and everyday use. I charged it to 100% and I made it to day 2 with 40% battery left. It was 2 light days of videos, socials, and gaming at 1440p and 120Hz. If I'm ever in a hurry and run out of battery, this phone supports 80W charging and is ultra fast charging. And I mean ultra fast. It takes 10 minutes to go from 0 to 50% or about 25 minutes from 0 to 100. You can actually watch the battery percentage increase with the 80W Super VOOC power adapter. For comparison, with a 45W power adapter that's not included, the S23 Ultra takes about 25 minutes from 0 to 50 and about 60 minutes from 0 to 100. The only downside is that there's no wireless charging, which is a bummer, but the crazy charging speeds make up for it. Almost. And before we continue, I want to take a quick minute to thank Ekster for sponsoring this portion of the video. Ekster creates durable yet stylish wallets made for the 21st century. They're made out of premium materials ranging from leather to aluminum and carbon fiber. I went from a thick bifold wallet to a sleek space-grade aluminum one. It's less than half the size. I opted for matte black, but there are 16 other colors and patterns you can choose from. It can hold up to 12 cards plus cash with the included expandable backplate. What I like about this wallet is the quick card access. With a click of a button, my cards will fan out for easy access. The wallet also blocks RFID to prevent wireless theft, and there's an optional tracker card, so you'll never lose it. If you're still using a bifold wallet, I highly recommend this one. And right now, they're currently having their Father's Day sale. Everything is 30% off. So this will be a great time to upgrade your dad's old wallet or yours to a sleek and modern one. And if you click the link below, you can get an additional 5% off. That's shop.ekster.com/kevintai, or you can use my code kevintai at checkout. I'm also going to leave that information in the description box below. So please check it out if you're interested. On the back, there's a triple camera system, a 50 megapixel main camera, a 48 megapixel ultrawide, and a 32 megapixel telephoto. The main camera takes really good photos. It's color accurate and very sharp, and I prefer these photos over the S23 Ultras, which are more saturated. I'm not sure if the color accuracy is due to their partnership with Hasselblad. Focus is pretty fast, and I don't need to worry about moving subjects. The ultrawide camera takes good photos too. It also does macro, and it's not bad, but not good either. You can't get really close like other phones without it being out of focus. The telephoto camera only has a 2x optical zoom and a 20x digital zoom. And for videos, the OnePlus 11 can shoot in 8K 24fps or 4K 60fps. Again, it's not bad. Overall, photos and videos are good, but not as good as flagships. The OnePlus 11 is a typical glass sandwich. Gorilla Glass Victus on the front, aluminum sides, and Gorilla Glass 5 on the back. The back is this textured matte black finish that glistens in the light. It looks cool, but the camera bump is kinda weird. At least I can use it as a spot to rest my finger. The front is a 6.7-inch, 120Hz, 1440p OLED display that can go up to 1300 nits. It's a very nice screen with accurate colors, but it curves over the edges a lot more than the S23 Ultra. There's a hole punch selfie in the corner, and a fingerprint reader under the screen. The phone is only IP64, so you don't want to drop it in water. And let's not forget about the alert slider. You can switch from ring, vibrate, or silent, all without unlocking the phone. Now if I stop right here, then I would daily this phone, but there are some little software quirks that I don't like. In notifications, if I have several from the same app, I can't swipe down to view them all. It'll bring up the settings tiles instead. I need to tap the bar or arrow to expand it, and seeing a preview of a specific one needs an additional tap. Another quirk is if you want a clear notification. You need to do a small swipe to the right. A small swipe to the left will bring up quick actions, and a long swipe will dismiss it. The default display size is a little too big for me. When I compare it to the S23 Ultra, you lose quite a bit of content. A few other small quirks are the slow animations, YouTube and YouTube Studio app are only 60 FPS, and the arrow to hide the keyboard is on the left side. And that's it for my long-term review of the OnePlus 11. Would you choose this over the other flagships? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'll be notified when I post new videos. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!